Looking at the statistics, coach, LCS have always been the tougher opponents for Kick for Life. I think in the league we've just won one match against them. Mm-hmm. We drew a couple of matches, lost some. In the first one we even drew. So I just want to get this one from you. What kind of game can we expect on Saturday? How are you approaching the game?
No, as usual, we are expecting a tough match. They always work harder than the other games when you look at them when they play. When they play Kick for Life, they are always on a different level. But at the same time, I think it's good for us because it's helping us to grow as a team, to play well. So yes, of course, the other matches again that we've played, we haven't won. I think we've only won one match, and most of the matches have been a draw. But we believe this time around, we are approaching the match in a very confident way because of the recent results. And yes, of course, also I know they will be coming again fighting. So it's just gonna be one of those tough encounters, you know? Yeah.
Okay. And looking at the log, this season LCS has not been at its best. They are just below you in the log standings. At the moment, Kick for Life is on the fifth position. Can we say you go into this match with an upper hand or maybe an advantage?
For me, like I said, I think the previous press conference, the log at times doesn't say much, because each match has its different merits, comes with its different, you know, forms. And we'll approach first. We definitely need the maximum points. We're gonna do well to be as offensive as much as we can, and definitely defensive qualities should be of high standard. And we expect them to be the same. So it's just a matter of us probably applying ourselves more so that luck can also play its part.
Okay.
Yeah.
And speaking of being offensive, you have just upgraded your attacking threat. And we know LCS is one of those teams that it's very difficult to break their defense. I mean, what can you say about you upgrading your attacking and also facing a team that when it comes to defending, they're very good at it?
Yeah, there are certain areas whereby they struggle. There are certain areas whereby they struggle. I think with the players that we've brought on board into our team, I think we're gonna, you know, actually, we're going to change a little bit of the way we've been playing, because you'd find most of the times when we apply ourselves in a certain manner, we find ourselves playing to their strength. So at this juncture, we want to change more, you know, and create those opportunities or chances whereby we can, you know, move them away from the areas that we want to attack. So hopefully it will work, especially with these players that have joined. So because they possess a certain way of playing, which we believe can also give us something in terms of trying to create goals.
All right, then maybe the last one, looking at the still on the on this game. How are you approaching this game? Are you approaching it with the full squad? Do you have any suspensions, absentees, injuries?
We approaching the match we regard this match as the one of our highlights, because like we said when we started, you know, it's been quite a while since we last won against LCS, so we are taking it as a final for us. So we take all the players that will be available 100% fit. They will see to it that we are given opportunity to play.
Okay. All right. Let's cross to the top eight. Hello, Chris. This is the second season in a row that the team will be competing in the top eight. From the management side, what are your thoughts?
Yeah, we're always very excited to take part in these competitions. Again, it shows the growth of the team over the last few years. Very exciting to be in there. As you saw from today's draw, there's a lot of quality teams. All teams with the same aim to win the competition. So it's a very good test for us. Again, it's another good way to measure how far we've come. Obviously, we've got a very, very difficult draw, but also one I think that we look forward to. Very exciting game against Matlama. I think it's one that everybody's looking forward to. You can see by the reaction at the draw today that everyone expects it to be one of the best games, I think, in the round. So, yeah, it's something we're really looking forward to being part of again this year.
Okay. And last season, we made it into the semifinals. Mm. Is there any special or any specific mandate this season?
Yeah, I mean, I always think with these competitions, you can't, especially for... in our position, we don't really set mandates. Every team goes into it wanting to win it and with a chance of winning it. So, of course, we'd all love to win the competition. I think first and foremost, let's focus on the Matlama game. Let's enjoy it and let's see how far we can get again this year.
All right, Coach. It's Matlama. What can you say about it?
A very good team, rich history, very good players around, talented players. The coach has done well since he joined the team, so surely it's not going to be an easy match, but we are looking forward to the day when we play them. I believe it will bring the best out of us, and we're just gonna go in there and do our level best to see to it that we enjoy the match, we secure the maximum points, and we go probably into the second round and the next rounds, but it's not going to be an easy encounter.
Well, in most cases, when you find yourself playing the cup competitions, the league matches, the biggest worry would be the fatigue levels amongst the players or the team. Are you not worried about it? Especially looking at the game that you'll be playing, Matlama, it's a very tough match.
Yes, of course, there are times where you'll have to sit down and work on your players managing fatigue levels. But I think at the present moment, our squad is fully fit. Things have been dealt with in a very professional manner. So I think at the present moment, we don't have any worries or question marks regarding to that.
Yeah. All right, just wrapping up with the request. Any special announcements regarding the top eight, the dates when the games will be played?
So the first leg will be next weekend, so weekend of 24th, 25th. I think the second leg is the weekend of 10th and 11th of March. But we're waiting to hear venue. So we'd be told the games will be at Maputsway and LCS, and they'll be double headers. So we're waiting to hear which ground we'll play at first and on which of the the particular days of the weekend. So obviously we'll communicate that as soon as we've been advised by the Premier League.
All right, thank you for your time.